I would like to talk to you about photo references. What do I paint? I tell people it's very important to paint your passion. Find out what you enjoy and take pictures of that because you're going to paint better. You're going to enjoy what you're painting. So whatever your passion is, if it's gardening, if it's animals, landscapes or snowscapes or seascapes, painting still life, whatever is your passion, start taking pictures of those. I always recommend getting a black and white picture and also a colored picture, 8.5 by 11 of whatever you're going to paint. Work big so you can see the image, it helps you. I say make your job easier by having a good reference that you can see. Black and white will always help you read value and a colored picture. So whenever I paint, I have black and white photo as well as a color photo, and I'm referring back and forth, checking my values. Pick simple subject matters when you start. Paint your coffee cup in the morning, simple objects that are cylinders, squares, circles, ellipses, simple shapes. Look at the masters. Look at Degas, Matisse, Rembrandt, Leonardo da Vinci. Study from the masters, look at their works. It's very inspiring. They were all well-trained and then eventually a lot of them went off and found their own styles. Go out and see art in your community. Go to art walks, go to galleries, go to art shows. Look at the styles, look at the colors, look at what's selling, look how they frame their work. Look at the techniques that they've used. I will always tell my students, get out there and look at the textures that they are using in these paintings. Once you start painting, you can find some other painters in the community and you can have little groups that meet once a week and paint together. It's very inspiring and helps you get through the journey of learning to paint. So those are some techniques on photo references on what to paint.